I had a wonderful time. I went to a luncheon, the Broward Women's Alliance, and I love going there. I meet such special people, and they always really have excellent speakers. But the last time, they had more than one speaker. And someone I had heard so much about and never met before was Senator Nan Rich. And she got up there, and she is a pistol, let me tell you. And she is on a real big tack for something, which I believe in so much. And Senator Rich, I have to tell you that you had all those people there. And I don't know how many people really knew about the Children's Services Council before, you know, you got there and talked about it. And the wonderful woman who runs it. What's her name?
Cindy Ehrenberg Seltzer.
Right.
In Broward County, right.
And she was great. But your enthusiasm comes, I think, with a lot of other things. But right now, let's talk about the Children's Services Council. And we're going to save it. And how are we going to do that?
We're going to vote on November 4th to reauthorize the Children's Services Council in Broward County and also in Palm Beach County, because they were both on the ballot as a result of a piece of legislation that passed a couple of years ago that put these Children's Services Councils back on the ballot for reauthorization, which is a whole other story. Okay, because...
But I think it's very important for our listeners who have no idea what the Children's Services Council is, does, or why we want to save it.
Okay.
It's
well,
your time.
The Children's Services Council, the whole concept started back in 1948 in Pinellas County. They were the first. They were called the Juvenile Welfare Board at the time. We don't use those words anymore. Not exactly positive, but they were the first one, and they are still going strong in existence today. We have 8 Children's Services Councils around the state of Florida. They're known by different names, and they provide, they are a taxing authority that provides funding in their counties for children's services, and each one has a little bit of a different emphasis. But the reason that they're there is because we don't have enough money for children's services in our counties around the state. The state is, as a legislator myself for 12 years, I can tell you the state is not very good on funding prevention, early intervention. And that's what a lot of these councils do. They fund literacy programs, early childhood programs, summer camps to, you know, keep kids occupied over the summer with in healthy experiences. There are a lot of after-school programs and programs for special needs children. In Broward County, it actually started as a result of a task force that was put together by the state attorney, because there were so many problems with children in the foster care system. And it ended up, of course, the report showing that we needed at that time approximately $100 million to meet the needs of children. Well, right now, the Children's Services Council in Broward County funds about $65 million worth of services. And let me just tell you, Anita, we cannot afford to lose those services to children in Broward County. And if this is not reauthorized, that's what happens. The Children's Taxing District, the Children's Services Council, would actually go away. And
well,
we can't let that happen.
No, we can't. And one thing you said, and that's why I asked you to come on our show, of course, is this show and Boomer Times has been dedicated to the seniors and now, of course, to the baby boomers. And you said that they really pulled you through, or us through, the last vote. So yay!
Yay for the seniors. In the year 2000, we went to ballot to create the Children's Services Council in Broward County. And at the time, I was actually chair of the Children's Services Board, which is a dependent county commission board. But we needed this independent district to provide provide funding for services. So there is a state statute that allows counties to go to ballot and decide if they want to create this for their own county. Palm Beach County has had it for quite some time. They are, as I said, also having to be reauthorized now, and they do an incredible job as well for children in Palm Beach County. So, but in 2000, we went to ballot, and we won with 59% of the vote at that time for this brand new concept. And now people really, it's done such an excellent job, such tremendous transparency, accountability, outcomes. We know it works. And that's why I believe there's so much support and will be so much support for this ballot initiative to continue it.
Senator Rich, I was very impressed with the statistics, and I usually don't do that, but I sat there with my mouth open about the success. I think people, if they only understood some of that, it would make mm-hmm. them say, why, for heaven's mm-hmm. sakes, is this not just something that continues?
Right. One of the areas, each county kind of has its own focus, and that's good because the needs are different in different counties. In Broward County, there's a big need for diversion programs for youth that have had some difficulty, you know, in school, and keep them out of detention centers and put them into programs that, you know, can help them learn and succeed. So that day when you were there at the lunch, Cindy went over the statistics for the diversion programs. And, you know, I think it was something like 96% actually for a year have, you know, stayed out of trouble, stayed clean. I mean, it's amazing the things that can be done. And we happen to have a wealth of providers in Broward County. There are over 150,000 children and families that are affected every year. And we have just incredible resources when it comes to providers that provide these services for children. I just want to go back for 1 second to the seniors, because in the year 2000, we were on a primary ballot, not a general. So in primaries, seniors overwhelmingly are the ones that vote. And people said, well, you're not going to pass because the seniors aren't going to vote for this. Well, let me tell you something. The seniors overwhelmingly voted for it. They understood the needs in the community. They understood, you know, that the safety and protection of children is important. They also understood the importance of a diversion program, of after-school programs to keep kids occupied in, you know, in significant, important, you know, work that keeps them off the streets and learning and continuing their education. So these are all incredible experiences that have happened as a result. And the seniors, you know, we went around from condo to condo talking about what this could do, and they overwhelmingly put this thing over the top. And I just have that, you know, sense that they're going to do the same thing again because they do understand the investment in the community.
I have such admiration for you. I mean, I wish this were TV right now because, you know, you have bitten a lot of bullets. And you've taken this on because you appreciate it and it comes from your heart, and people should mm-hmm. understand that. And you're, you know, you're well educated, you're tried and true. And if this is that great, and I think people trust you, people should do it. But I want to just, and we'll come back to, because I want people to understand what some of the services are. I want to go back to something that's troubling you a little bit on the ballot. Let's get that cleared.
Yeah. The absentee ballots, and this is the ballot, obviously, that will be used on Election Day, came out, and the question, the county question on the reauthorization of the Children's Services Council, is on the same page as the three constitutional amendments. And it's one column is Constitutional Amendment 1, second column is 2, and the third column is the third constitutional amendment, but also the county question. So some people seem to be missing it, thinking that these are only the constitutional questions. And if they vote no on the Constitutional Amendment 3, which many people are doing, they're continuing on down and either voting no or missing the county question. So we just want to alert everybody that gets an absentee ballot to look carefully on the page with the constitutional amendments where there are those three, but then on the second half of the Constitutional Amendment 3 is the county question. And we urge everybody, obviously, to vote yes to retain the council and the wonderful programs
and what,
it provides.
What would happen if it went no?
What happens is that the council, the Children's Services Council, would go away because it would no longer have the authority for the small amount of property tax that is, you know, that created and funds the Children's Services Council.
And I'm
so
going to
it
pursue
would go
that
away
further.
And, that,
and now what? Okay, so it's gone away. Let's really get down into the big, dirty part of this. What happens now?
Okay. Well, as I said, you have over 150,000 children a year that, are the recipients of these services. And what happens is that there's no funding for these services. So you're talking about, and the providers, we have a network of over 100 providers in Broward County, people like ARC Broward, which serves special needs children, the Boys and Girls Clubs, the Y, Family Central, which does, you know, child care, Hispanic Unity, Kids in Distress, go on and on and on, Healthy Mothers, Healthy Babies. These are all incredible providers and resources in our community that are funded to the tune of $65 million through the Children's Services Council. It is the umbrella in our agency, in our county. And whatever the services are, as I said, whether they are, you know, actually one in four children in Broward County receive services through the Children's Services Council. So you're, as I said, you're talking about literacy programs, you're talking about early childhood child care, you're talking about summer programs that provide summer jobs. Over 1,000 kids last year participated in that. You have programs dealing with children with developmental needs and after-school programs, delinquency prevention, as I mentioned, and diversion programs. These are all things that are funded through this money. And if the money is not there, the services cannot take place.
And I just
so it would
want
be devastating.
People, yeah, I want people
devastating.
To envision that. I want people to
yeah.
envision that.
Yeah.
So where a family now is struggling, but at least their child has a place after school to go, and the parents have people to talk to. I mean, I'm very aware of mm-hmm. these kinds of services. Now mm-hmm. they don't. So now the next thing we see, more crime. We see more homelessness. So it's so easy.
Children failing in school
yeah, I mean,
because
I mean,
they haven't been given the right foundation, you know, the proper early childhood education, the literacy programs, the things that get a child ready for school. Many of these early intervention programs are funded through the Children's Services Council.
And knowing people, at least up in the Palm Beach County, it's really very much the same. It's just a different mm-hmm. county in a sense. I know how they work. These are social workers. These are people who they don't make a lot of money. They're not on Wall Street, everybody. They struggle, but they love what they do. They're like school teachers in a way. They really see making a difference, and I've been privileged to see the difference that families have had because of it. Kids going to college that never could have gone to college. I can't even imagine this not passing. So everyone yeah. that listens to this show, right. I will come out from the microphone into your
into
home
your house,
if
right.
you do not vote yes.
Right, right. Well, and, you know, this is, it's exciting that the both of the newspapers, Miami Herald and the Sun Sentinel, have come out with strong endorsements for it. And it all relates to the fact that, you know, this is money that's being well spent. There's a lot of transparency, oversight. Outcome measures that if you don't meet them, you don't get the money again. And that's really important that the programs do what they say they're going to do and help the children the way they say.
Yes, and that's something that probably 20 years ago was not happening, not with this group particularly, but accountability now is the word. When you
right.
get money, we want to see what you do. And that's why I was so impressed with the slideshow that mm-hmm. you put on at the Broward Women's Alliance. And I don't know that the legislatures, is there any way that you could give them, couldn't you have done the same slideshow for them? They wouldn't have sat there, would they?
You know what? You know, they're the ones that caused us to have to reauthorize this, put it on the ballot. And you know, this is the sad part about it.
Yeah, talk about that, because I don't think people understood that.
This is the sad part about it. There already was a mechanism for any county to go back and ask their county commission to put it on the ballot to consider whether or not the county wanted to keep the Children's Services Council. That's part of the original statute creating back in 1948 the original Children's Services, the Juvenile Welfare Board in Pinellas. And in all that time, not one county ever went back to ask whether or not, you know, where the voters came and said, we don't want it. You know, we want you to put it on the ballot. It has never happened. So we had a legislator who didn't like something that was going on in his county, something that was being funded. And he picked on, and I say this, picked on the Children's Services Councils, only 8 of them. Okay. In the entire state. I wish there were 67 in every single county, but okay. We have 8 that are benefiting from this. But there are over 1,600 taxing districts in the state of Florida. Why pick on the children? And then, I mean, I can go down a list of taxing districts that you could probably get rid of in this state and nobody would care or know the difference. But we do know the difference with children, and that's the point here. Why pick on these kids? And now what has to happen is you have to run a campaign. Once it goes on the ballot, you have to raise money. You have to, you know, make sure that you can get your message out to the public. So that money could be going for children's services. That's how I look at it, instead of going for TV ads and mailings and, you know, hiring people to run a campaign. Right, so, and that, obviously this is separate money. I want people to understand that this is separate money that has nothing to do with the money that comes in for the Children's Services Council. People have, I was on the original steering committee in 2000. We went out, we raised money, you know, to help get it passed. So it's an entirely separate entity. The Children's Services Council has nothing to do per se with the campaign part of it,
because
they are
a
501c3, and this is something else, a political campaign.
Let me just read a little bit about who you're listening to. Nan Rich is an American politician for the state of Florida. She served as a Democratic member of the Florida Senate from 2004 to 2012. She also served as Senate Minority Leader from 2010 to 2012 and was term limited out of the Senate in 2012. Too bad. She served in the Florida House of Representatives from 2000 to 2004, and she was a candidate for governor of Florida in 2014. And I was so excited about that. And I know there's all this, just one of those things that happened, but you would have made a wonderful governor.
Well, thank you.
But you're doing what you can do in a different way. And
exactly.
And you don't know. You're young. You know, never know what will happen, right?
That's
I wrote
correct.
A book with my husband called Live to Be 100 Plus. So
okay.
We have lots of years.
I'll have to read that.
you're doing it all anyway. You have to have a passion, as you do. And so you were talking about, I was once on the board of the ARC in Palm Beach County, Association mm-hmm. of Retarded Citizens. And, what they did was amazing. And so I understand this, and I can't fathom the idea that this mm-hmm. would not be voted on.
Right.
Yes.
When I was in the legislature, every year I went to the kindergarten, the preschool graduation at ARC in
Absolutely.
Broward County.
Isn't that amazing?
And it just you weep tears of joy to be able to see what has been accomplished with these children, with the proper care and education. And it's just amazing what they are able to do. And then many of them get mainstreamed then and go on into public school. Some not, but most of them do. And it's just amazing, all because of what ARC has been able to do. And then you just kind of multiply that by. I happen to be on the board of Kids in Distress. Kids in Distress gets quite a bit of funding for their programs, foster care programs.
Talk about
programs.
Kids in Distress. Go ahead and talk about that.
Yeah. Well,
what are they? Who? What happens?
Well, these are kids is really a child abuse prevention program, trying to make sure that kids are safe, whether they're, there used to be much more of, being in kind of group homes than there is today. They run a foster care program, making sure that we have good quality foster homes to place children in. They have a very good preschool program there. So many, many ways and counseling for families to make sure that child abuse is prevented and that there is, not any recidivism there with it. When it has happened. So, I mean, it's quite a, an outstanding program, but, you have, as I mentioned, programs like Healthy Mothers, Healthy Babies, which helps early on with, making sure that mothers get the right information early. Many of these programs start even, before children are born, so that they can get the education
right,
that they
I remember
need.
Them
Everyone
carrying
doesn't...
around dolls so
yeah.
that they could see what yeah. it's like. You yeah. never put your doll down
right.
because that's what's going to like them.
Right.
Yeah. Well, I remember when I wish we could have had the legislatures or that particular person that you were talking about do this. I remember when Senator Graham had his once a month workday.
Mm-hmm.
And he went, and if see, he went, would have gone to Children in Distress. He would have gone to something like that.
Right.
So he understood what really, you know, these are words otherwise.
Yeah.
It's hard,
right.
Even though you're
right.
Articulate, until you sit there and you see what happens when the family comes in and there isn't enough food or they're all sleeping in one bedroom. No one really can appreciate that. I know on Thanksgiving I did a lot of volunteering and I would go to homes to bring turkey and hear people blind, you know, they I mean, you really get the feeling then when you do it. And a lot of people don't do it, so they don't understand.
Right.
So what you're doing is you're trying to put it all into one big, lovely basket and say, look, this basket can make so many people happy. It's not a lot of money because if you didn't have the basket, it would be a lot of money.
Well,
I think if you don't have the basket, you're going to see money going like crazy out of the windows.
I mean, because you increase your criminal justice system. And you increase your prison population, which is a heck of a lot more expensive than early intervention and prevention services. And one of the things that we can brag about with Children's Services Council in Broward is that 96% of every tax dollar goes to programs and services for children. The administrative costs are 4%.
Oh,
so
that is amazing.
You're talking 4%. About every is that all of this money goes directly to these programs for children. And the other thing that I like particularly about Broward County's that I know about it may be the case with all of them, which I believe it is, but I know for a fact with Broward that they have worked very hard to bring all the funding sources together to make sure that there's no duplication. So because for many years, you know, this one did this program, this one did this program, but we have tried very hard to have everybody create their niche. So that, you know, someone is doing special needs, someone is doing, literacy, someone is doing, you know, foster care, so that you have, as I said, you don't have this duplication. One of the things I'm doing Friday is there's a wonderful program in Broward called Handy, which is for children aging out of the foster care system. And it's been a very strong focus of mine in the legislature over the 12 years that I was there, because we have had to do a lot to provide better care for kids that are aging out. At 18, you know, think about it, and all your listeners, you know, would you have thrown your kids out on the street at the age of 18 with no health care, with no visible means of support? Most of them haven't even graduated from high school yet. So these types of programs are ones that are helping here. I'm going to visit Handy on Friday. They have a kind of a brown bag lunch, you know, to listen to some of the kids. And you talk about some of them coming up to testify in Tallahassee. These kids come up. They have a group that had been created a few years ago. And they come up and they testify before the legislature. Who better than a former foster child kid who's gone through the system, maybe 5, 6, 7 foster homes, can come to the legislature and say, this is really, in my opinion, what you need to do to make this system better. And,
I love it.
You know, so this
is
these are the things that happen with this. And we just need to make sure that we get the information out and everyone is educated and understands, you know, what they do and what a loss it would be, just irreparable in our county without this funding for these
programs.
Are you
worried about this?
You know,
I mean, how do you feel about
it? I feel really good about it. I feel good about it. Much more so than in 2000 when we were doing it for the first time and we had opposition from the county commission. They wanted to be the umbrella, but they weren't funding to be the umbrella. You know, you have to take up the mantle of being able to do the funding if you want to be the umbrella for everybody. So it was a little more difficult. And then, you know, and as I said, we have the both newspapers now have, you know, given really strong endorsements. So because they see what this does for the counties. And
if you say if it is a yes, that means it won't come up again. Isn't that what an amendment would do?
Yes. This amendment, what it does, it says that it would not come up again other than by the statute. In other words, as I mentioned earlier, there is something in the statute which is still on the books that would allow people to go to their county commission and say, we'd like this put back on the ballot. But there would be no automatic, you know, every 8 years, 10 years, whatever, you know, reauthorization. And that's what we're looking for, is just this is in perpetuity, with the exception of what the statute says. And that's the way it should be. The statute has always allowed it. The voters have never done it because they've never felt the need to do it because of the excellence of what these Children's Services Councils do in each of their communities.
And so that's really very important that you said that, in a sense, because if something went awry, something were not good, there is an out.
There is a mechanism, absolutely, absolutely. And that's what we argued at the time, that there was no reason to do this. All it was doing was causing counties and, you know, to have to create a political campaign to make sure that it was reauthorized. And there was no reason to do that, because you already had the mechanism to do it if something was wrong.
My guest, this passionate woman you've been listening to, is the former Florida State Senator Nan Rich. And unfortunately, she didn't stay in the race for governor, but you never know. But she's a dynamo woman, and she has a great cause, and we all want to support her. So remember, you want to vote yes, and you want to go underneath the Third Amendment.
Make sure
all the way to the bottom, right?
On the county question, it says, county question, reauthorization of the Children's Services Council of Broward County. And I'll put the plug in for Palm Beach County as well, because they do a great job too.
Because it's all doing the right things. But I just want to say that our listeners, they really care about a lot of things. So a lot of medical, we have a lot of very important issues on this show. Mm-hmm. And as they know, I don't do a lot of politics, but I felt this was so important. And I can't thank you and your busy schedule to come here and share your passion with everyone. So thank you, Senator Rich. We really did enjoy this.
Thank you, Anita. Enjoyed being here. Great. Thanks.